And I must say, it's as always a pleasure to arrive to Moldova. I have been here many times before, and the reason why we are here is that we are involved in a court case that basically not follow what we think in a proper way to handle a court case in Moldova. The case basically started already back in 2005 with no involvement of that company I represent, a Swedish bank called Skandinaviska Enskilda Banken. We were then suddenly involved by a correspondent account back in 2006. So you're not talking about a court case that has been going on for basically 6 to 7 years. And during 2008, a court decision was taken here in Moldova without any hearing from our side, SEB Bank in Ukraine. That's why we hardly believe that this court case as such has not followed normal rules and regulation in Moldova. And what we have done after that, of course, we have been then heavily involved to try to also to meet persons to make sure that we get attention to the case. And now during the latest 6 months, we have met the Minister of Justice, we have met the Minister of Foreign Affairs, we have also met the head of Anti-Corruption Committee here in Moldova. So there has been started an investigation how to sort out and how to handle this case in the best way in the future. But my point is that if we as foreign investors in a country like Moldova should be able to handle our investment in a proper, good way, there must be rules and regulation followed by the court system. And this case as such has not followed ordinary court regulations and rules.
So that means that you lost lots of money?
We still haven't lost any money directly, because the court case has been going on since 2006. It never ends, and today we also were in the court outside of Chisinau, and now it was prolonged again. So next date is the 22nd of May. So this case basically, as it looks, should be closed already during 2006 related to our involvement. And that is still not the case, so we will continue to do.
Which is the part who is not, do you think is not interested in ending this case?
I can just speculate about that because I don't know. But I mean, you can just imagine by yourself that we as bank has not been involved in any circumstances in this case from the very beginning. Suddenly a bank called Victoria Bank back in 2006 had a correspondent account in SEB Bank in Ukraine in the amount of 8,000 hryvnias, is similar to 800 euro. That claim that was then addressed to SEB Bank was on $247,000. Then suddenly in 2008, this claim was $1,247,000. So my best guess, but that is only what I can guess, is that somebody is trying to get this court system in the way to get out money of this court decision. But we cannot, of course, in any way allow that that will happen. That's why we have been all the time appealing in those court cases to make sure that this has to be stopped. And then once again, that's why we have met all those persons on high level in Moldova, Minister of Justice, Minister of Foreign Affairs, the head of anti-corruption, to make sure that we get attention. Today we have had got attention. Some investigation has started, but it takes so long time to fulfill it.
How do you think this will affect the image of Moldova, and how will do you think this will scare investors to come again and to invest in our country?
I have been in bank business for over 42 years. What is very important in all societies, especially in countries like all former Eastern European countries that are in transmission period, is to try to establish a court system that people trust in as much as possible. Because that is the key element in society, is to be able to have a court system that you really trust, you are treated fair.
Who is involved? Russia and Ukraine?
There is a regulation back in 1993 that between the former CIS countries like then Russia, Belarus, Ukraine, Moldova, there is an agreement saying that if a court decision is taken, for example, in Moldova, you can just then simplify things to go to have an assistance court decision taken, for example, in Ukraine, and by that go directly out to the counterparty and claim the money and collect the money. So that is an old regulation. That's why we also have to, let's say, make sure that this court decision as such are stopped both in Ukraine and also in Russia. And we have done that because if not, of course, we have activities as a European bank both in Russia and also in Ukraine. And if it doesn't stop it, of course, some authorities in those countries can knock on our door and then collect the money.